Welcome to the Metals Daily News, brought to you by Metals Update, the driving force behind your business. I am Neha Kamle from the Mumbai office on 14 June 2017. According to the National Bureau of Statistics, the industrial production for China, which is the broadest measure of factory output, increased by 6.5% in May from a year earlier. The production is in line with the 6.5% increase in April, but decreased from the March multi-year high of 7.6%. The retail sales, which measure private and government spending, increased by 10.7% year-on-year, also in line with the measurement in April. The annual fixed asset investment, which gives an overview of long-term spending, increased by 8.6% in January to May period. LME 3-month nickel prices fell to a year low on Monday at $8,795 per ton. The prices improved by a marginal 0.06% in Tuesday's trade. The flooding of market with cheap nickel ores is considered to be the major reason for the nickel's downfall. Nickel ore is a cheaper alternative to refined metal for China's vast steel mills, which use the metal to add strength to stainless steel. The market is also struggling with decreasing demand for nickel and high stocks, leading to decrease in prices. The renewed supply of cheap nickel ore is causing further concerns. The supply of nickel ore is increased as Indonesia and Philippines have increased their shipments of nickel ore after Indonesia relaxed an ore export ban earlier this year. Therefore, some nickel mines are on the verge of closing down as operational cost is exceeding the LME price of nickel. Brazil's Vale plans to suspend two of its older, high-cost Canadian mines this year. The Reserve Bank of India, RBI, on Tuesday said 12 accounts representing about 25% of the gross bad loans in the banking system would be eligible for immediate reference for bankruptcy proceedings. The Reserve Bank, based on the recommendations of the Internal Advisory Committee, will be issuing directions to banks to file for insolvency proceedings under the IBC in respect of the identified accounts, and such cases will be accorded priority by the National Company Law Tribunal. Steel is one of the six major sectors which have been saddled with the non-performing assets, including power, roads, highways and telecom. Therefore, market expectations are that steel companies can be under the primary scanner as soon as RBI releases names of these 12 accounts. Metals Update assess offers of MS scrap from the Mandi Gobindgarh market at ₹19,600 per ton, while fresh scrap is being offered at ₹22,000 per ton. Offers of MS ingots at Mandi Gobindgarh are currently quoted at ₹27,300 per ton, while at Raipur and Muzaffarnagar the offers have been recorded at ₹24,900 and ₹26,200 per ton respectively. In international offers, the Djibouti origin HMS 1 and 2 scrap is available at $260 per ton on FOB basis and $310 per metric ton CFIT. Liberia origin HMS 1 and 2 used rails are available at $204 per metric ton CFR Turkey and $265 per metric ton at CFR Italy. Also, the steel billets 5SP of 150mm are available at $380 per metric ton on FOB basis at Bandar Abbas. Thank you for watching. Join me again tomorrow for the latest updates from the metals market. Visit metalsupdate.com for more information and do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.